Let's start our meditation practice. Please sit comfortable position. Sit very comfortably. Keep your back straight as much as you can. Gently close your eyes. Gently bring your attention to your body. Now take a few long breaths and relax your whole body. Relax your head, your face, neck, shoulders, your left arm, right arm, also your chest, your belly, up of the left leg, low of the left leg, up of the right leg, low of the right leg. Relax your whole body. Relax your mind. Relax. 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 Let's practice loving kindness meditation. Make the bhavana. Save yourself. Bless yourself. Wish to yourself. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. Understand the meaning of each word deeply and clearly. Then repeat it yourself. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. If you can make a little smile in your face, you may feel your loving kindness. That energy. Just make a little smile in your face and repeat these three words again and again to yourself. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. Thank you. positive energetic words, also thoughts. It can change yourself. You are the person who can bring happiness to yourself. That happiness is so powerful, nobody can change it, because you made that happiness to yourself. And thinking and repeating, also chanting these three words, you can make your own happiness, you can make your own joyfulness. Happiness is within yourself, it is not somewhere else. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. May I be free from stress and also dangerous difficulties. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. If you have any difficult thoughts in your mind which is bothering for your journey, you can think about it now and you can list yourself. For example, may I be free from anger, jealousy, ego. May I be well. May I be happy. May I be peaceful. husband or wife, children, brother or sisters, girlfriend, boyfriend or best friend, also your co-workers, your neighbors, who close to you, who so far from to you, and bless to them. May my family be well, be happy, be peaceful. May they be well, may they be happy, may they be peaceful. May my family free from dangers, free from stress. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be peaceful. If you have any difficult people in your life, just imagine his or her smile, face, and listen to them. May my difficult people be well, be happy, be peaceful. send this spiritual, powerful thoughts to around human beings. Don't separate the people, black or white, Hindu or Muslim, Christian or Buddhist. Just think we all are human. We all members in large family. Then wish to them, wish to them. May all living beings, human, non-human, also this environment, be well, be happy, be peaceful. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be peaceful. Now slowly turn your attention to your breath. Take a few long breaths and understand your breathing process. Mindfully observe each breath. Breathing mindfully. Breathe out mindfully. then you can understand or identify your breath very clearly. How do you understand, identify your breath? Sometimes you are taking deep breath, understand, I took deep breath. Sometimes you take short breaths, understand, I took short breaths. In this practice, it is so important to understand your breathing process. Now you are breathing very aware, every breath you take very mindfully, understand what is the purpose of this breath. Breath is our life. We use another word for our breath. We say prana. Prana means breath. Another word, life. Without breath, no life. We cannot stay, we are going to die. It means if somebody understands about this breathing process, that person can understand the reality of the life. And also keep your mind, you cannot breathe past breath, you cannot breathe future breath, just you have to breathe present breath. It has very deep meaning. The deep meaning is you have to live in the present moment, because of this moment is wonderful moment. Today, we are going to do special chanting for Patty Erickson Ma. Now she is in the hospital because she has COVID-19. And also another friend, she is so close to us. Today we are going to do some blessing for these friends and all the living beings who has that COVID-19, who suffers COVID-19, and please just take few minutes. Please practice loving kindness to them. Just think about that mom, that the excellent mom, and also that friend. And if you know somebody who got already that virus, please think about them. And please send that spiritual, powerful, loving kindness thoughts to them. Because in this situation, they need this spiritual, powerful, energetic thoughts. We cannot do anything, but your mind is so powerful. You created so many powerful, energetic vibrations. Now you can send that all the spiritual things to them. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be peaceful. May they all come from that suffering of COVID-19. May they be well. Just think and send that spiritual thoughts to them. Now we are going to do the chanting. And please listen to this chant. Just cultivate your spiritual thoughts.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Karaniya matta kusalena yantam santam padam abhisamiccha. Sampo ujucha sujucha suvacho chasya muduvanati mani santusya kocha subarocha ampakinchocha salla ukautti santindriyocha
make a strong determination to practice this meditation every day, at least 2 minutes. May peace be with you. May all living beings be well, happy and peaceful. Thank you very much. Open your eyes. Good evening, everybody. So, how are you today? Thank you so much for coming today. I was thinking about today's talks and what I'm going to talk about today. Then I got two different ideas. There are two wonderful, beautiful, meaningful words in teaching of the Buddha. I think sometime you already know that two words. I think words are so powerful, right? And if you use, you know, meaningless words, we can destroy this world. If you use meaningful words, we can, you know, protect, and we can make this world like a beautiful place, right? Words are so powerful. That's why Buddha include that point in his teaching in Eight Noble Path, right? Speech. It is so important. There are two words in Buddha's teaching. First one is we call Ehipassika. Ehipassika. Other word is we call Puna Puna. Puna Puna. Ehipassika means, Ehi means come. Passika means see. Come and see. In Buddha's teaching, Buddha told us, just come and see. He never said, come and believe. He just said, come and see. What? Where? We have another two questions. What and where? Buddha said, come and see. What? We're inside. What's going on inside? Normally, as a human, we are, you know, used to look at outside, what's going on outside. But we are not, you know, put more attention to our inside, what's going on inside. But Buddha said, it is so important to do some research and observation about your inside, what's going on. It is so important because we are, you know, working so hard and trying to get our happiness, trying to make our happiness because we need it, right? It is not somewhere else, it is your inside. You are the person who can bring happiness for you, right? It means, first of all, you have to understand your characteristic behavior and also your. Then you can understand your inside. When we try to understand our inside, there are two investigations we have to do. First one is, we have to investigate ourselves, yourselves, your behavior, your characteristic. Second one, your thoughts, your mind and thoughts, we can say like that. How do we investigate our thought and also our mind? We know this mind and thoughts work together. When you are getting angry, you say, I'm getting angry. It means you have angry mind at that time, right? When you are getting happy feeling, then you can you can feel you are happy, it means you have happy mind. It means that two things are working together. Right? And it means we need to investigate our thoughts, then we can investigate our mind. If you investigate your mind, it means you investigate your thought. Right? And it's like, you know, two hands. If you wash your right hand, you have to use your left hand. Right? If you wash your left hand, you have to use your right hand. Like that, right? Yeah, same way, same thing going on your inside. When you observe, when you investigate your thought, it means you investigate other side of your mind. Right? And when you investigate your mind, there are two minds in there. In Pali we call padutta chitta, pasanna chitta. Padutta chitta means bad mind, unwholesome mind, unpleasant mind, undisturbed mind. I think we all have that one, right? And other mind is equal pasanna chitta, pleasant mind, good mind, skillful mind, and wholesome mind. Normally I use, you know, two words for them. For good mind, I said, you know, diamond mind. Bad mind, I use demon mind. We have that two minds, diamond mind and demon mind. Now think, when you are getting angry, what mind you have? Demon mind. Now you have diamond mind. It is so shiny, right? It is so beautiful, right? And when we investigate ourselves, our mind, we can find that two kinds of mind. Why would the thought to investigate that two mind? Because we all have two options. We all have two options. Right? What are they? When we observe, explore a good mind, we can see there are so many good thoughts in there. Some thoughts are so nice, you know, loving kindness, compassion, joyfulness, generosity, wisdom. There are so many good, skillful thoughts in our good mind. Then Buddha said, just pick up one thought. Which one is strong in your good mind? It could be loving kindness. It could be compassion, joyfulness, generosity. Whatever it is, Buddha said, just develop it, cultivate it. Right? And again Buddha said, if you cannot see any good thoughts in your good mind, don't worry, just explore your bad mind. When you explore your bad mind, you can see bad, there are so many bad thoughts in there, you know, 100,000 thoughts, and anger, jealousy, right, delusion, hatred, so many. Then Buddha said, just pick up one thought, which one is strong in your bad mind. It could be anger, it could be jealousy, it could be delusion, hatred. Whatever it is, Buddha said, try to eradicate it, try to move it. When you eradicate your strong bad mind, what happened on the side? Your good minds come up. It means, my friend, we all have two options. That two options come from two minds. Observing good mind and also observing bad mind, and pick up which one is strong in there and cultivate it. Other one we have to eradicate. Right? Then we can make our peace. Then we can make our happiness. That happiness is so important, nobody can change it. Because that happiness is coming through yourself. It is not coming from somewhere else. Right? That's why Buddha taught to us to, you know, go to inside. Ehi pasika, come and see. Go inside and see what's going on your inside. It is so important. Can you keep that word in your mind? Ehi pasika. Repeat after me. Ehi pasika. Ehi pasika. Ahi means come, Astika means see. Right? When you repeat that word, when you, you know, remember that word, you have to go your inside, right? That is the magic. Okay. And second word is we call Puna Puna. P-U-N-A Puna Puna. Puna Puna means again and again. Again and again. Now think. When you woke up, you have to make your breakfast every day, again and again. Right? You have to brush your teeth again and again. You have to clean your room again and again. You have to wash your bathroom again and again. Now you are not, you know, brushing your teeth. What happened? Is it good? No, it is stinky. Then nobody close to you, right? Huh? It means we have to brush our teeth again and again. You are not cleaning your dining room. What happened? Then you cannot enjoy your dinner. It means you have to clean your dining room again and again. You have to wash your clothes again and again. Normally, regularly, we do that all things again and again, every day, right? Every day, you have to work every day, again and again. You have to drive to your workplace again and again, every day, right? You have to come to this building again and again. You have to practice this meditation again and again. Yeah, right? Regularly, we are doing everything again and again. That same concept you have to apply to your life. You have to focus on your mind again and again. You have to focus on your weaknesses again and again until it fixed. Right? It's going to fix. You have to focus on it. You have to observe it. Again and again. Right? Buddha said, every day when you woke up and until you go to bed, you have to observe whatever your thoughts come to your mind, good or bad, you have to observe it again and again. Right? When I, you know, think about these words, I could remember another beautiful story. One day, you know, I checked my Facebook, then I saw, you know, beautiful picture. In that picture, there was a boy. He is, you know, I think he had a stick, his right hand. And other side, there is a roaming wolf or something, cow. Now this, then I was thinking, oh, sometime this cow is not controlled. That's why that boy had a stick. Maybe that boy was thinking this cow is going to somewhere else. Maybe he hit the cow very gently with that stick and he get that cow same path, same road. Right? Now think, sometimes our mind is like a cow. It is not controlled. It is trying to go, you know, everywhere. And you have to find a stick. A stick means concentration. You have to hit the mind with the concentration, then you can get your mind back to your body. Otherwise, your mind is going to be like a weird cow. Weird cow. Now think about that image. And that picture, just think that idea, your mind like a cow. Buddha taught same thing. It is so, you know, rowdy, and try to go everywhere, jumping everywhere. Sometimes we say, you know, monkey man, and sometimes we call, you know, cow, and sometimes we say, you know, wild animal. There are so many names for our mind because it is so hard to control. That's why, right? But when your mind tries to go anywhere, you have to hit the mind with the concentration. How? When? I think you experienced already during your practice time, your mind is go to your back to your home, right? Then you have to hit the mind. How? Oh, my mind is somewhere else. My mind is going to my room, my house. You have to think three ways like that. Then you can get your mind back to the path. Right? It means you try to aware your concentration. Okay? Please keep these two ideas, two words in your mind. It's so important. First one, ekipasika, come and see where you are inside. Another one, puna puna, again and again. You have practiced this meditation again and again. You have to participate this, you know, meditation session again and again. We have to do the dharma talk again and again. Right? Okay, please keep these two ideas, two words.